Flack here. I'd like to read you a story today. I apologise, sorry in advance, you can't see my face. I'm using my phone to read this story to you, and I can't quite coordinate myself so you can see everything at once. So hopefully you should just get the story and the pictures. This is my children's, one of their favourite stories that we read, so I hope you enjoy it as well. It's called The Cave by Rob Hodgson. There is a cave. A cave that is home to a little creature. A little creature that never leaves its cave. Because of a wolf. Why don't you come out to play? The little creature asks the wolf. I'm sure we'd be very good friends. No, thank you, replies the little creature. I already have two friends. So the little creature stays home. The wolf comes back day after day. Why don't you come out to play, little creature? Asks the wolf. I bet you're so bored in there, all cooped up in your cave. No, thank you, replies the little creature. Only boring creatures get bored. So the little creature stays home. The wolf never leaves. Not even to go to sleep. But the little creature never comes out. It doesn't want to climb a tree or play ball or pick flowers, and it definitely doesn't want to feed the birds. Why don't you come out to play, little creature? Asks the wolf. Eventually, I'm getting hungry now. You must be getting hungry now. The little creature sniffs. Now you mention it, I am a little hungry. Well, says the wolf, I have the most tasty donut here with your name on it. Why don't you come and get it? Does it have sprinkles? The little creature asks. Yes, shouts the wolf. And with a stretch and a shuffle, the little creature... comes out to play. Oh my goodness. Not so little. I do love donuts, says the bear, but I'm still a little hungry. Ooh, where's the wolf gone? Oh my goodness. Why don't you come out to play, little creature? Says the bear. I'm sure we'd be very good friends. And that's the end of the story. I hope you've enjoyed it. Just a little activity for you. If you remember, the bear, the little creature, he said he had two friends. I wonder if, as you listen to the story, maybe you might like to listen to it again, whether you can see who the two little friends are. There's a clue on the front of this book. Okay, bye-bye everyone. Stay safe and hopefully see you all soon. Bye.